Mr. Rockstar KC
and Mr. Marketology
invite everybody to join us at our brand new town for the number one rated morning show at
10 a.m. in the morning.
Live on the Real 1100 AM and iHeartRadio all over the world.
And that's Monday through Friday. Woo! Woo!
Thinking about retirement? Make sure a My Social Security account is a part of your plan. A My Social Security account gives you secure access to your personal earnings history and benefit status. You can find out if you're eligible to receive benefits, compare retirement benefit estimates at different ages or dates, view spousal benefit estimates, and more. Plan for your future. Open a My Social Security account at ssa.gov/myaccount. Social Security, securing today and tomorrow. Produced at U.S. taxpayer expense.
You are tuned into WWWE Yorkville, AM 1100.
The following program is paid for by Influencer 365. The views expressed do not necessarily reflect the views of this station, its management, or the Beasley Media Group.
Uh-oh. Sounds like somebody's got a case of the Mondays.
It may not mean nothing to y'all, but understand nothing was done for me. So I don't plan on stopping at all. I want it forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine. I'm shutting shit down in the mall. It's selling there, girl, she the one for me. And I ain't even planning to call. I want it forever, mine, ever mine.
Woo! And we are back right here on the Real 1100 AM iHeartRadio, checking in one time.
All over the world.
It is the number one rated business show right here, 10 a.m. Well, we the number one rated morning show now.
Yeah, business show and morning show.
I don't like to brag about, you know how
we're the number one rated morning business show or business morning show.
However you want to put it, we number one. Ladies and gentlemen, thank y'all for joining us again right here on the Real 1100 AM iHeartRadio, checking in all over the world for another Mindset Monday, and it's going to be an awesome show today.
It is.
Back by special demand.
What?
We got the expert in the house, the world-renowned astrologer. He tore it up on Friday so much, everybody hitting us in the comments, everybody hitting us in the messages, say y'all got to bring it back one more time.
Yep, we're going to talk about the stars.
I say he here every week, ain't that enough? Hey. Lord have mercy. Thank y'all so much. The number one rated audience. We love y'all so much for joining us. Right there on LinkedIn, Twitter, YouTube,
Twitch,
Facebook, Instagram, all over the world. Thank y'all so much for joining us.
My television.
You gotta get them in front of that television, man.
Hey, we're gonna be on TV soon, man. We're gonna go ahead and put this thing on Roku and some of these other channels.
You too. Ready to do it?
I'm ready to do it.
Hey, I'm gonna need you all to up my contract a little bit before you
come. Oh, once you get on TV?
Yeah, you might have to.
Look, he already brand new. He up there. I need my makeup artist,
but
and
you
I need
know
my
now we on all the other platforms.
I need the red M&M.
See?
Once again, joining us in the house today, in studio with us, the one and only world-renowned astrologer, Mr. Lorenzo Sanford.
Hey, man, thank you for being here.
Lorenzo, we're going to talk about them stars around Chris Rock's head.
Chris Rock got it, didn't he?
Ooh.
It was a night last night.
It was like Bugs Bunny. Yep, it was like Bugs Bunny, like tweet, 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 tweet.
You know, I can't wait to find out what the real deal is.
Like, oh, yeah.
I know people in those circles. I can't wait to find
out explore it today.
What happened.
We're going to talk
gonna go
about
into it a little bit today.
And you know, I've always got my views. And my views are expressed are not the views of Beasley Media, Real 1100, iHeart, anybody else.
Not, oh, my goodness. I'm still battling these allergies.
Hey, man, my car is green right now. It's
man,
a lime
it's
green.
It, bro. It's yeah. like the sniffles and all those other types of stuff.
Yeah,
but I visited my friends over at West Park Wellness. Mm-hmm. Got me another free COVID test.
I know they sick of you.
Oh, bro! Every time I sniffle now, I need a test.
I know they sick of you.
Hey,
bro.
They said they donated $2 every time I show up. Hey, but no, I visited my friends over at West Park Wellness. Got the free non-invasive saliva PCR test. I got my results back in 24 hours this time because the numbers have come down in Georgia,
mm-hmm.
so we don't need these tests just quite as much, but. Just to be on the safe side, you know, I got kids and everything, bro. I got to stay healthy.
Mm-hmm.
I got to stay myself. I got to mm-hmm. stay right.
Mm-hmm.
So I got my test done. It was non-invasive. Nice saliva test like you like, Joe.
Yeah, yeah.
Got my results back in 24 hours. I'm COVID-free.
I went by the Dollar Tree and got my test. And you know, I went to the Dollar Tree and picked me up one of my COVID tested. And you know,
they said I was good.
Yeah, they said I was good. Now I don't know if the plus, the minus, the blue, the yellow, I don't know, but
at least I think you may want to investigate the plus and the minus. But, those distinctions are important.
If you out there and need some free weekly mobile COVID testing, I want you to call visit my friends West Park Wellness online at westparkwellness.com. They'll come out to your business, event, school, restaurant, church, gym, wedding, funeral, concert, barbershop, or house salon. It's a 5-person minimum, and they are still donating $2 per week to a nonprofit of your choice. Once again, that is the rapid non-invasive saliva PCR test.
Yeah.
They'll come out between 8 to 6 Monday through Friday and Saturdays 9 to 5 just to make sure everybody in your community, in your business, in your home or whatever is safe and free of COVID.
Their office hours are?
I don't
know. Yeah. Yeah. So don't call them at 10 at night talking about, I need a test.
If you need a test, bro, you need a test.
They have office hours.
You got to be serious about your health, Jeff.
If you about to go to the club, do not call them at 10. Yeah, do not call them at 10 at night talking about, I need a test.
Lord have mercy. If you are about to go to the club and you're in need of a haircut, I want you to visit my friends over at Studio 1211. The all my men like to look good.
Mm-hmm.
Stay looking sexy, stay fly, keep a nice line on you, whatever. I want you to go visit my friends at Studio 1211. You can see my personal barber, Melvin. Just give him a call at 770-485-6772.
Miles is playing the buzz.
Yeah.
And if my haircuts be fly, I ain't even worried about it, okay? I get so many compliments
and if you need
on my haircut.
If you need your hair dyed.
I feel sorry for you. If you are trying to stay in shape this year, if you're trying to stay fit, you want to get your spirit right, get your mind right, get your body right, I want you to visit my friends over at Titans Fitness. They're a world-class training facility. They got fitness programs and nutrition, brand new Vitality Center, so you can get your chemistry right, you can get your meals right, you can get your body right.
If you need to bulk up before you get slapped on stage, you might want to go to Titans Fitness.
Join Jeff for some cheeseburgers at 12 o'clock today.
If you need to bulk up just in case somebody steps on stage and slaps fire out of you.
Bro, I cannot wait.
But you know what? Oh, my God.
You're not that guy.
I cannot wait to get into that. But lastly, if your business is slow this year, If you're not seeing the growth that you want, if the year is not coming together like you thought it would, we at the end of the first quarter, a lot of businesses are telling us that they're slow. They're not seeing the type of cash flow. They're not seeing the type of customers that they thought they would. Jeff and I are teaming up to help just a few businesses.
Yeah. Yeah. A handful of businesses.
Just a handful. Cause we don't like taking on a lot of clients because I don't like to work no more. I got to be honest.
You know.
But no, we want to do our part. We want to help y'all. So definitely. Send an email to connect@kevincpride.com. Just let us know you want help with your business. We'll give you a free 15-minute consultation, and we'll talk about your problems that you're having right now, and we'll talk about how we get you going and how we get you growing.
Exactly. We're going to get you money.
Man, KC.
Just straight to the point.
KC stands for Kevin? I thought you had a more distinguished name like Kenneth or...
No, you did not.
It's Kevin.
My mama beautifully named me Kevin Christopher Pride, okay?
Oh, I was going to say Kevin Charles, but...
I thought it was like Kenneth or...
Kevin. I am the one and only Kevin C. Pride. Trust me, y'all don't want another.
So, Kevin Chris.
Kirkland? Oh, my God.
Conklin.
But you know, Kevin became a bad name for a while, for real. You know what I'm saying? Nobody like you, Kevin.
Yeah, exactly. Kevin.
But it's all right, though. Thank you, Mama, for naming me a good night. All right? It's going to help me in my political career.
I was named a distinguished name. It's Jeffrey. You see how it rolls off your tongue? Jeffrey.
What's that butler rich name on Fresh Prince?
Yeah, I was thinking the same.
But he was a rich, but he was a rich butler.
Yeah, he was.
Yes.
Man, anyway, this is a business. So what we got for our marketing minute for the day?
The marketing minute for the day is stay ready. Stay ready. Don't get ready. Stay ready. So last night, we saw all what happened. But I noticed on TikTok, there were people that had actual skits of this.
Oh, no. Not
on TikTok
already?
30 minutes. And they already had like 100,000 views.
Whoa.
And 100,000 likes.
Oh, yeah.
They were ready. I mean,
the jaw didn't even heal right. The bruise was still there, and they already had it up on TikTok with 100,000 likes.
That's amazing.
They stayed ready.
You know what they're talking about?
So for all of y'all that did not watch the Oscars, like half the country. All right. Matter of fact, do we got the audio from the Oscars? Let's just play the scenario out real quick, because y'all ain't going to stop talking about it until we talk about it. So let's get into it real quick, because number one, I cannot believe this mess. All right. Number two, I still can't believe I saw that. And number three, oh my God. Let's go ahead and play this audio real quick.
Jada, I love you. G.I. Jane 2, can't wait to see it. All right. That was a nice one. Okay. I'm out here. Uh-oh. Richard. Oh, wow. Wow. Will Smith just smacked the shit out of me. Wow, dude.
Yes.
It was a G.I. Jane joke.
Keep my wife's name out your f***ing mouth.
I'm going to, okay? Okay.
My ex's name out your mouth. You know, I was going to come across that table last week on Kevin. I remember.
And Kevin's going to whoop your ass.
I had to hold you back. I talked to you.
You had to hold me back.
I was telling you, you know, the planetary energy is not right for that kind of thing.
But let's think about this. Now let's start from this premise.
Strong, though. I had the baby powder and everything.
Exactly. But no, exactly. Let's start from this premise here.
You're not that guy.
But let's start from this premise. Nobody has been watching the Oscars.
Yes.
Who knew the Oscars was on last night?
Not me.
Before this.
And it revitalized the Oscars.
I didn't know it either.
Look, Miles, but you watch TV all day, every day. You don't, you know.
And I ain't even know.
You know what? I think I agree with what you're going with this.
But now, think about this, though.
I think I know where you're going.
Now, was this moment staged? Was it not? Or is this just the Oscars capitalizing on something that they know is shock value and they're going to get a lot of attention for? Because you got to believe they on every headline, they being talked about by every news show.
Yep.
Every talk show this morning is talking about Will Smith slapping the S out of Chris Rock.
Yeah.
I have that same thought. It's just, it's kind of unimaginable that a man would know that he's on international live television and will walk up and slap another man in the face.
And let me give y'all this too, working on the other side of TV and the production side, nothing goes on that screen that ain't playing. And
exactly.
They know what's going on before it go on.
And here's the thing.
Exactly.
Now, you know, I'm going to get into conspiracy. If you notice, Chris Rock leaned forward into that slap.
I didn't
see
that.
He leaned into that slap.
Now, I say this. I thought at first, when he walked up and smacked him, it was a joke. But when Will Smith sat down and started cursing and yelling.
And we never see that from Will Smith.
Yes. That's what I'm saying. That is so off-brand for him.
Yes.
That is so out of his character to be that type of person. Now, I realize the movie that we talked about, he just did, King Richard.
Yeah.
Okay, but still, it's no reason to even try to market that at this point. Because if he was getting an Oscar for that movie, he knew he was getting that damn Oscar either way.
But here's the thing. Do we know what other movies are coming out? What movies are they going to do together? What movies Chris Rock and Will Smith might be in? What next role does Will Smith got to be in? He might be in a real gangster role in his next movie. And this is just, now Will's not the soft Will that we thought he was.
But don't nobody want to see you be a gangster in real life, bro. You the Fresh Prince. Like,
first
for real.
Of all, we've seen BET Awards. We've seen how this really go down when you go slap somebody on stage.
You get shot at the BET Awards.
But what I'm saying is, where was Chris Rock's boys? Where was the security?
Man, Chris Rock ain't got no boys.
First of all, there was no security that was like, Will, come on now. You can't just go up and slap somebody.
Chris got that crossover now. Trust me. You don't get boys on that side.
Well,
that's some BET stuff, though.
If it wasn't staged, then you have to give Chris Rock a lot of credit because he was the ultimate professional.
He definitely was that.
He stood up there, and after he got slapped on live international television.
And look at his reaction afterwards.
He got a little flustered.
He did.
That's what I'm saying. That wasn't the reaction. Like, I knew I was finna get smacked.
Right.
Well, I mean, he might not have known he was going to get slapped that hard. He probably known it was coming, just not that hard.
No, there was a point where he was embarrassed. And just before he introduced that next award, mm-hmm. he was kind of like...
It was a pause.
A pause and a loss for words.
Yep. Yeah.
But look, I promise you all, I know people on the inside. I'm gonna have the real scoop next
you're
week.
You're gonna get the scoop.
Get I promise dirt. You.
But we need
two,
to know.
These two have a little history. Yeah, I mean, with Chris Rock. Yeah, with Chris Rock talking about Jada. This happened in 2016 when Jada and Will said they were gonna boycott the awards.
Oh wow!
Rock was hosting the Oscars and he did this joke.
Is she on a TV show? Jada boycotting the Oscars is like me boycotting Rihanna's panties. I wasn't invited. Jada's mad. Her man, Will, was not nominated for concussion. I get it. I get it. Tell the truth. I get it. I get it. You get mad. She said it's not fair that Will was this good and didn't get nominated. Yeah, you're right. It's also not fair that Will was paid $20 million for Wild Wild West.
But I don't think that's right.
No,
comedians.
That is, what was that, 2016?
2016.
So that's 5 years?
Yeah.
6 years? That's 6 years of buildup Will had. He was like, I'm going to slap you for that joke. But 6 years later.
But it ain't like Chris Rock telling the joke about Will Smith every day.
What I'm
like
saying
we putting something out there about him.
But it's such a big stage, though.
It is a big stage. Don't get me wrong.
And if Will's anything like me, I still hold grudges from people from kindergarten. Will ain't letting that go.
And Jada and Chris have worked together on movies, Madagascar series. They were both actors. Right. So you don't know what those two have.
That's true.
You know.
Exactly.
I ain't letting nothing ride.
Don't forget Jazz Moon and Scorpio. So he's not going to forget
anything. He had no problem with grudges.
And that's a great segue for us, right? Because we're talking about obsession.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
And Scorpio energy is the most obsessed energy that there is.
Well, let's end this like this. Y'all let us know in the comments. Do y'all think this was a staged event between Chris Rock and Will Smith? But y'all think this is something that really just got under Will's skin? Because honestly, if you look at minutes before he walked up on that stage, Jada expression ain't no smile, bro.
Nah, she was mad.
And
about
everybody
that
had that look where you sitting here all giggling, and your girl look at you like.
Right again, well, she was like, "Again, you're doing it again.
Yeah.
Why do I have to be on your?"
Exactly.
But Will was laughing. Like
huh?
Nothing. I'm gonna get off that.
But the topic for Mindset Monday today, the obsession to be better. In the United States, people spend millions and millions and millions of dollars on self-help courses, on self-development. On buying the right things, buying the right status symbol. Why are we so obsessed with being better?
Because we're always told we're not good enough. We're trying to be accepted. And we're told we're not good enough by so many different sources.
Well, not only that, but more specifically, Madison Avenue, the advertising industry, is trying to fool us and make us think that we're not better. And make us think that we need to be sexier. We need to be thinner. We need to have whiter teeth. We need to have longer, straighter hair.
That's true.
You know? And so that's why I don't have hair, because I wanted to make sure that I'm not boycotting all of that.
But no, it's let me tell you the premise for this, because I was thinking as I came in this morning, because I love self-development. I love self-help, motivation, all this type of stuff. And I've spent over 20 years being obsessed with being better.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Trying to be better than being better than who I was, who I was raised as. I don't know. But what I found was at 42 years old, I'm still the same person. I got the same flaws. I still got the same attitudes about stuff. I still have a lot of the same habits and some of the same negatives.
But,
you know what I'm saying?
But the beautiful thing is you have now, just by saying that and acknowledging that, you are doing the first thing that was told by ancients to their disciples and the people who were under them. Know thyself. You know who you are, son. That's a beautiful thing. That's a beautiful
thing.
You know who you are.
That's big, man.
But it's like we get so obsessed with this word better, better, better. What's better?
Well,
you know what I'm saying? What gets better?
That's the problem. Since like Lorenzo said, if you don't know yourself, you don't know what better looks like anyway. Because you don't know the basis to base that on.
Okay.
You know, I mean, if you don't know who you are and you don't know who you want to be, then you don't know what better looks like. You just think it's better than what it is now.
Okay.
Now, look, I am no religious scholar, obviously, but there is a verse in the Bible where it says that God clothed the birds and gave them everything they need. So why wouldn't he give you everything that you need?
Yeah, that's the one that pastors don't like to talk about around collection time.
Oh, yeah.
You have everything that you need already.
Exactly.
And you're born with an innate strength. You're born with an innate beauty. You're born with innate intelligence.
You're born with intelligence.
So, I mean, so again, there's all these constructs, and some of the constructs are false, and it's because of capitalism. People want to make you feel like you have to spend your money to buy these beauty products.
Yeah, that's true.
And cars and my Ferrari, my Portofino M. I don't need a Portofino M Ferrari, but I am going to have one day, right? I send it every week on this show.
But what'll be better about you when you get it?
Well, it will be a better ride. It will be
a
better experience.
I'll put the top down and I'll
the
see you all
shine better. That water that I'm selling on the side of the road.
But now, especially as entrepreneurs, a lot of times we get so obsessed with either I need the right circumstance, I need the perfect circumstances, or I'm not good enough yet, or I'm not, you know, this yet. I need something to be better.
What you need more than anything is the right relationships with the right-minded people to work with, the same like-minded people. Because if you're working together as we are working together, then you get a chance to grow, and we all grow.
Okay.
Right. We all lift each other up. But if you're if you have a mindset that I'm going to do it on my own, or I've got more than somebody else, so I'm better than somebody else, those are all things that are going to keep you locked into that isolationist stage. But we grow together.
Now, let me go back to I like where you're going there. And let me go back to something Jeff just said. He says it's about being accepted. You know what I'm saying? It's about trying to feel accepted and this type of stuff. But it's my premise that you only feel unaccepted because you don't accept yourself.
Well,
because let me say why I say that. As I'm getting older, mm-hmm. like seriously, it's starting to be some things I had to accept. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I can't sustain the same lifestyle of a 20-year-old like I used to live.
I keep telling you that.
In my 40s.
Yeah, you can't be clubbing like you were 20. You got to be in the station in the morning. You can't
my life,
hang out.
I'm going to enjoy it.
You can't hang out till 5, 6 in the morning on a weekday. It's a school day, Kevin.
And then I got to give them your breakfast. I got to do it. It's a lot. But no, it's some limitations I'm starting to have to accept as a grown man. You know what I'm saying? I ain't got that same energy I used to have. You know, I had to slow down at some point.
You know, there's a reason why you can't be elected president of the United States until you're 42, right? Because they recognize that everyone goes through cycles of growth, and you have not had your complete maturity until you reach that age.
That makes sense.
Wow. And that also ties into astrological cycles too, because we know that Saturn is what matures us as it goes through the horoscope. And so when Saturn reaches a certain point, then you've developed a certain awareness because you've experienced everything. And it's not until you've experienced everything that you can say, I am a man or I am a woman.
Mm.
So there's cycles of growth. And so at 42, everything you're saying right now is perfect. Okay. So you are in the right place.
So
in the right place.
So if they were 20-year-olds in the White House, they'd be turned up.
Oh, Lord have mercy. Do you all remember? I'm not trying to be disparaging, but do you all remember Kwame Kilpatrick,
mm-hmm.
the mayor of Detroit?
Detroit.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Who got? I think he's still in jail, isn't he? And I know, and I've one of my best friends is a cop in Detroit, and the parties that they used to have at the mayor's house in Detroit were legendary.
Wow.
But he was young. He was arrogant. He didn't know himself. He didn't know his responsibility. He hadn't been through the cycles of maturity that are necessary for that kind of power.
Yeah.
So how do we begin the process of accepting ourselves for who we are and this type of stuff? Because the older I'm getting, I'm starting to accept this is who you are. You don't like this. You like this. This is you know, who you need to be in this type of stuff. How do people get to that point of truly, truly accepting this is my good, this is my bad, this is who I am. I just gotta roll with it.
Well, to quote another spiritual tradition, Buddhism tells us that you are already good because the nature of humanity is that you are rooted to the one source. And if you're rooted and connected to the one source, you are already inherently good. Okay. So you have to come to an acceptance of your Buddha mind or your Buddha nature, because that is the truth of you. We all come from a spirit, whether or not you're a religious, whether or not you call it Allah, Jesus, Buddha, Krishna, we all come from one source. Mm-hmm. And even if you come from a scientific place, you don't know what to call that source. We all came from atoms and those small cellular roots is what Rootless. I'm trying to say. Okay. And so there's a oneness about us all. And if you accept that you're good already and that you're a part of life, then you don't have to beat yourself up.
Okay.
You can accept yourself. And we talk always on this show about envisioning who you see yourself as, keeping that in your mind. We are like the creator in that we can create, we can change by what we see for ourselves. Mm-hmm. What you hold on to in your subconscious is what is going to manifest in your life.
Wow.
Is it not?
Yeah, that's true.
That's true.
Is it not true? I mean, I am, I'm trying to be like you because I see, you know, this beautiful gray hair and this distinguishedness.
Yes. Years and years of stress.
Ain't nobody got to try to be like me.
Stress. Yeah, I'm not trying to be light skinned.
Yeah. That's how I love my light skinned.
Well, we are going to come back after the break and talk about this. And I am opening up my class of slap therapy.
Oh my God.
Yes. If you can't seem to get it together,
and if you bring your slap therapy over here, if I'm gonna open up this can of whoop ass.
Seem to get it together, these hands will help thy get yourself in order.
Lord have mercy, this is another Mindset Monday right here on the Real 1100 AM iHeartRadio, checking in all over the world. It's the number one rated business show with your host, KC Pride.
And Mr. Marketology, put these hands down on you.
And Lorenzo Sanford from Astrologic Astrology.
And we'll be right back after this.
Hi, this is Dr. Williams with Align for Life Wellness. I want to invite you to our new office at 1800 Jonesboro Road in Atlanta. Come in for a consultation, examination, therapy, and x-ray, all for just $100.
What?
Yes, $100. This offer expires soon, so call us to schedule at 404-383-1110 or find us on the web at www.yourfinespine.com.
If you want to be fine, take care of your spine.
We're open late.
And now, an important message from Steve Harvey.
This pandemic isn't over yet. We got the vaccines. I got mine. You might have yours. But listen to this. Don't think just because you got the vaccine that you could just go crazy. Follow the current safety guidelines. I know the mask is hot, but you know what's hotter than these masks? Staying healthy. That's pretty fly, if you ask me. Let's unite to prevent.
For more information, visit unitetoprevent.org.
Tune your radio.
Tune in.
Now.
You can tune in to this radio station on any smartphone or tablet.
iPhone.
Android.
BlackBerry.
Nokia.
Samsung.
Windows phones.
Or whatever you have. Download the free TuneIn app from your phone or tablet's app store.
Tune in with music, sports, news, and comedy.
From over 70,000 radio stations around the world, including this Beasley Broadcast Group station. Check it out at TuneIn.com.
Or your app store.
Hey y'all, it's Paris Fit, and I'm rocking with KC Pride, the host of the number one rated business show.
Fast forward 5 years, $5 million crib, South Fulton, I pop it, land. Won't let nobody mock it, land. I brought millions of dollars.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back.
Test 1, 2. Miles, can I hear myself a little bit better?
Turn the headphones up on.
I think you turned her up.
Oh, okay. Okay. They haven't said difficulties right now.
There you go. Thank you.
Okay. This is what happens when you're doing a live show.
Turn her down.
We all in postcards right now talking about turning y'all headphones.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're back right here on the number one rated business show right here on Real 1100 AM iHeartRadio. It's the astrological business forecast for the week.
Yes, sir.
What we got this week with our world-renowned astrologer, Mr. Lorenzo Sanford.
It's an interesting week, man, because we have some contradictory influences. So you have to be really sensitive to work out this energy this week. So on one hand, Venus and Saturn are conjunct today. They're in the same place in Aquarius. So Venus and Saturn is when you have to pull back, when you have to bring things in and constrain yourself. You can't take chances. You cannot be risky. It's a time for conservative investments this week. Like, you do not want to be speculating on pork bellies.
Okay.
You know, you want to hold, go back to bonds. You want to go back to the types of investments that are going to be secure for long term. And so maybe it's because of the oil and all of the things that are affecting the market, but you don't want to be out there in big risky ventures. You want to come back to the conservative. You know, you're not looking for 14%. You're looking for 8, 9, 10%. Return. So it's a time to really come pull back, come back in and constrain yourself. However, we also have Neptune and Jupiter conjunct. And so if you have any dreams, if you're creative, if you have a spirit of wanting to be adventurous in the realm of your creativity, then you can start to formulate some plans because you're going to have some inspiration. It's a very inspirational time for people who have an open mind and a very creative mind. So if you have something you want to do, you've been dreaming of doing, put it down on paper and start figuring out how it's going to grow. Wow. It's not time to act on it, but be open to it. Don't be afraid to dream right now. And I know that's contradictory, but you can do both. You can pull back on the practical level. Mm-hmm. And at the same time, open your mind and your spirit up to the creative things that you want to do in the future.
Wow. Okay. Well, I need to call my broker. We need to pause some things. Say we need to pull back on some of the investments.
Yeah.
No, thank you so much for that, man. That is so insightful. Now, when you say we need to be a little bit more conservative, that means that we need to just pull back on all our investments, or we just need to look at the more rational investments that we can make?
Both. I think you have to pull back and you have to be looking at the more rational investments. You have to do both.
Wow.
This is not a time to take risk.
Well, y'all folks out there investing, y'all folks getting ready to start these businesses, y'all might want to take a close look at this advice for the week.
Man, my like, pork seriously. Belly stock's going to plummet.
That's all right, though. Just wait there, get ready to start rebuilding Ukraine. We just need to find out the companies that got them contracts, indeed. Bro. That's what we're going to invest
out. Yes, indeed. True. Now you're speaking a word.
Folks be looking at the wrong thing when it comes to investments, dog.
You're speaking a word now, son.
But finishing the conversation real quick. Getting over the obsession to be better.
Yeah.
Stop waiting on the perfect chance or the perfect circumstances. Stop trying to make yourself perfect and just get out there and do what you want to do, because trust me, you're gonna wake up the same person every day. Some days you might wake up motivated, some days you might not, but you still gonna be you, and you still gonna have every flaw that you got now. So you might as well just get up off your butt and go and do what you want to do and stop waiting.
That's true. Now when I say I'm perfect in every way, I meant that.
We believe you, Joe.
Nah, you didn't believe me last week.
You like, he like Trump. You know how you tell the same lie over and over again, and then folks start to believe it.
See, he didn't believe me last week. See, I say same lie. It's the truth, Kevin.
I don't even want to be perfect, man.
I'm perfect. I'm getting to the point.
I'm getting to the point, honestly, bro. I can be happy with my imperfectness.
You know, this morning when I woke up and I went into the bathroom, the mirror said, "Hey, man.
Oh my God. You got a magic mirror at the house.
You are perfect.
You are fake news.
We need to find out where Jeff live at, because he got Leroy cutting hair on the corner. He got folk working out on the corner. Now he got a magic mirror in his house.
Slick Rick said it in his song. You know, when you wake up in the morning, you like that. Your mirror talked to you.
But you are perfect,
Jeff. In every way.
You are perfect. There's Jeff. Some you are perfectly Jeff.
There's some wisdom in what both of you are saying. And I really appreciate what you're saying, KC, because you're coming to a really deep acceptance of who you are. We all need that. And Jeff, you are expressing this sense that we all need, that we are not only okay, we are beautiful. We are thriving. We are. Yeah. We are all that we need. So you both are very wise, and you both are doing the things that we need to be aware of.
Thank you, man. See, you ain't gonna kill my joy, Kevin.
I don't want to kill your joy. I want you to be happy, Joe.
Kill my joy.
I want you to be happy.
Go talk to my therapist after this.
But what are some steps or some people can take to really start to come to these realizations in life? Because I really feel like this is one of the big things that really hold folks back, it's one of them crippling type things, because it's funny. I've gone to so many different self-development conferences. I done seen Grant. I done seen Tony. I done seen, you know, JT Fox, all these different folks, and you see the same folks at every last one of them.
I mean, I honestly, you know, I'm not being about promoting myself, but I believe that the toolkit that astrology provides for looking into yourself in detail,
that's true,
is unparalleled. And I'm an advocate of astrology because I know it works. And all these personality tests, when you go to get a new job, mm-hmm. they want to give you these assessments. They're all based in the astrological system. They all make different variations on it, but it's telling you what your temperament is, what your inclinations are, what your social, the ways that you react to things socially. These are all things that you get from an understanding of your makeup astrologically. And KC, you know, you've had.
No, I can't lie, man. When I sat down and did that initial with you, and you gave me my whole birth chart, you read me like a book. It was like, wow, this is really who I am. And this is really how I feel. But most importantly, this is why. This is where it's coming from. You know what I'm saying? So now I understand that temper that is just right there at the surface at all times. You know, it comes through the fact that I got the Aries in my
Aries moon, baby. Aries moon on fire. Yeah. On fire for life, though.
You can't keep being mad, bro.
No, but he doesn't stay mad. He lets it out and then he keeps going. And that's what that Aries is about. I'm going to keep going. You're not gonna stop me. That's what makes you so inspirational to people, because they see how you've come up and how you're rising. So you've taken the challenging parts. Some, you know, it's not bad. You're saying the good and the bad. And I'm saying challenging is not necessarily bad. It helps you grow, right?
Oh yeah.
So now you've got a pathway to deal with that. You take your challenges move forward.
I know a lot of times what ends up happening, especially in, like, you know, different relationships and this type of stuff, even in business, you know, you get hurt in certain circumstances. And then that wall, that defense mechanism come up. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times that's what it is. It's like when somebody tap up against you or whatever, then that defense mechanism come up, and it's a way of protecting you. Unfortunately, it hurt other people. But it's a hell of a defense for yourself. You know what I'm saying?
Can't be scared to cry too, man.
I'm not afraid to cry, Jeff. I tell you, I got girls. Okay? I have lived with a house full of women my entire life, for real. So it's like emotions is nothing to me, bro. But, me and cry, Jeff. It's okay.
But
you ain't got to keep doing it in your closet at home in the dark, man. You can show some emotion, man.
He has Scorpio moon. I keep telling you that Scorpio
moon.
He
got that poker face.
He's gonna repress it. Yes. Yep. You're not gonna ever see it until he punches you in the face.
That's right. But no, seriously,
he showed us the way.
What is some practical steps that somebody can do and start taking today to start changing their life and stop being so obsessed with trying to be better and be obsessed with trying to act and actually do something about what you're thinking versus just sitting there thinking it all the time?
The same things that we say often: create a vision for yourself, mm-hmm. create affirmations that you can say daily so that you can reprogram your mind, mm-hmm. get yourself out into the world and network with like-minded people so that you're surrounding yourself in a web of people who are moving in the same direction you are. Learn how to cut and let go of the people who don't serve you, right? Mm-hmm. Keep your body and your mind in tune. That means you got to get out and exercise. You got to eat right. You know, you have to do all the basic things that are about maintaining this sense that I am worthy, I am important, I deserve good things, and I'm going to keep surrounding myself with good things. So vision, and then practical things every day to support the vision.
You know, one big thing, we're gonna have to do a show on your bubble, like, for real, because we live in such a siloed society now. Mm-hmm. And no matter what your opinion might be, it's a whole bunch of folks out there that you can go find that'll support that opinion, whether you're right, wrong, or otherwise.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? So we definitely got to talking about what your circle should
now. Notice how you looked at me when you said your bubble. I thought you was talking to me directly. I was like, wait a minute, hold
Let
on.
The guilty speak first.
I'm just saying.
Say in the South, hit dog will holler.
Yeah. I'm just saying. He kind of looked directly in my eyes when he said it. I was like, wait a minute, what about my bubble?
Now, once again, The Beautiful Logic of Astrology. It is a wonderful book about astrology. Like I say, it is a great read. Very easy read, too. You can get through it in one sitting, like, seriously.
And what is one of the highlights of the book? The artwork in The Beautiful Astrology is amazing.
And as promised, we do have the illustrator of the book in here. with us today. Yes. The one and only.
The one and only.
Miss Vivian McDuffie. How are we doing
Miss
today?
Miss Vivian McDuffie.
Hi. Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm overwhelmed by all this talent I'm surrounded by, that gift to gab.
My mama told me I talked a lot.
With substance. With substance.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
With substance.
Now
I try to pull Kevin up. I mean, sometimes you know.
I was speaking over everyone.
Thank you. You notice she light skinned, though. That's why she's so beautiful and glowing over there.
Here we go. Here we go.
Okay.
But I'm so glad we had a chance to get you in here, because the artwork inside this book is just gorgeous. It's beautiful. Like, where do you get the inspiration and the passion from to create art like this? Because to start with a blank canvas and then just create something just so vivid and so just unimaginable, where does that come from?
In this case, many, many people have illustrated the signs, the 12 signs. And so there was a history. So I investigated that and said, I want to do something different. And if you see my work, in particular, where there are human beings being illustrated, they're down to earth human beings. They don't seem so celestial or going like, for instance, Virgo, which is, what is the sign of Virgo? The Virgin, but more than that, she is an earth sign.
Yes, she's an earth
So
sign.
I planted her on the earth.
Okay.
She's passing by an enormous tree, and there's some growth in the background, and you can bring your vision of what you think it, what your view of what you think. Anytime someone looks at art, there's not a guarantee of what you all see. Everybody brings their experience to it, even when it's very representational.
Okay.
You know, if a man is holding a hoe, you can identify differently from him if you've had the experience, or if you've been the person that had him doing the work.
And that's interesting. You said you did the research. I mean, a lot of people, I think that you just pick up a pen or a paintbrush and you just slap something on the canvas and make it. But
I have not evolved to that kind of experience. There are people who do that, you know. When I'm approaching something that's abstract, I have no idea what I'm going to do. So I just begin, and then things sort of develop from there. But in this case, I was commissioned by my son-in-law to do his book. And that's when you have to direct it toward a specific subject. He asked me one day, do I have an audience in mind when I work? And normally I don't. You know, even when I'm doing representational things, sometimes I want to make a political statement.
Okay.
And other times it's a very personal statement. Mm-hmm. And they tend to be involve humans or symbols of human interest. But with the abstract, and this is called flipping, because there are people who only do representational work and do it very beautifully. It looks almost like a photograph, or it can be very... more like a Monet, you know, where it's the other thing. But anyway, with my abstracts, I just sort of push paint around, and sometimes it develops into something that's identifiable to me. And I might develop that and becomes more representational. Other times I just go with the more abstractness of it. I have a client who only likes, I don't say, she only purchases my abstract work, you know. And the first time I encountered her was when she was walking through a building I had a very large piece on. She said, I want that. And it's a lot of money what she paid. I was overwhelmed that somebody actually paid what I was asking.
Now you're a very, very accomplished artist. You, your work is being seen all over New Jersey at the Rail Hudson Berger Line. At MLK Drive in Jersey City, your work is being seen everywhere. How did you be able to get these type of opportunities to do such just amazing work for like cities and this type of thing?
Well, there's a competition for some commissions, and New Jersey Transit put out a call for artists to give ideas of what could be at a particular place. And the first commission I got from them, I was competing with many, many artists, but they said they wanted to represent what was happening at that particular area. And so I decided that I wanted to represent Branch Brook Park, which is a national park. It's has been designated national park, and it goes from Newark into all the suburbs of Newark. It touches them. And this particular station landed right there. And you can enter the station from the park itself, or you can enter from Danforth Avenue. And so I submitted ideas for that station, and I came in second. 11 people were competing, and I knew the guy that won it. He deserved it, I guess. But to come in second was such a great thing that later New Jersey Transit invited me without any competition to use my design in another space.
Oh, in other words, it was fixed the first time. But
I don't think so. I think it was a real competition. But you're sitting on a board of people. Some know more about art than others. But they also, even if you know a lot about art, you can have different opinions that you know in any subject. And they decided on Charlie, so Charlie got it. But the beautiful thing that happened was that later I applied for one at another station, didn't get it, but then they had a need for work to do something. And they said, we want you to take the thing you did for Danforth and put it here. And the commission went up more because they said, make out your budget and be sure to pay yourself well.
Oh, so I love that.
More money.
Yeah. So it turned out to be a better opportunity for me in the long run, even though I didn't get the first thing. But the thing I come from that from is don't count yourself out and always try. If an opportunity opens up, don't think you're not worthy of taking advantage of it because you're not quite ready. And I've made that mistake many, many times. I don't want to show there. I'm not quite ready for that. And the only thing I regret is not trying.
You've been doing art your entire life. What gave you this love of art and wanting to be a painter and be an artist at this level?
Well, you get a lot of what information you get about yourself is how people react to you. And I remember that in kindergarten, or it wasn't kindergarten, it was first grade, doesn't matter. I was upset, and I was at a little Catholic school in New York City. I was upset and I was crying, and the nun said, I don't know why she's crying. She does such beautiful work. They were trying to cheer me up, you know? And that's when my ego got wind that I was doing pretty things, you know, or whatever they like. And over the years, I got that kind of response. But when I went away to school, I said, that's not a practical profession. And I decided, because I loved math, that I would major in engineering, because all the boys I was competing with in my high school, I was making better grades than they were in math. But only in math. I had not taken physics and all of that. And that's what was my thing that I found out. Once I majored in engineering, I found out this is not what I want to do. And I took an art course, and teacher, instructor said, I ran into him on campus one day. He said, what are you trying to do? I said, what are you talking about? He said, this engineering stuff. He said, I tell students, they usually have a lot to get from creating art, but you have something to give. He said, anyway, you're going to be an uncivil engineer.
Wow.
So that was another clue to go with my real passion. I dropped out of school, got married, and had a child and all of that before I went back to school. And I said, it's going to be art.
Wow. And that's interesting, because a lot of times you hear people talk about living your passion, you know, working within your purpose and so forth. But they don't really define what that is. They say it after the success. They don't say it while they were in the struggle, that they actually was like, I knew. But you really gave the roadmap. You was like, okay, when I had the acknowledgement in the first grade, I knew I had something. But then when I tried to look at something else, I was steered back into what it was. But I knew all of this built up to who I am today. And I think that says a lot about knowing what your purpose is and knowing what your passion is and not just looking at it from a, you know, financial aspect or somebody else telling you this is what you're going to be. Because you thought you were going to be an engineer. It was like,
But as being an engineer, you need a passion for that.
But honestly, though, it takes tremendous courage to do that. Because you say you took a profession that you knew you could make money in and decided to walk away from that to go into a profession where you really did. It was kind of an unknown.
I was never going to make money as an engineer. I would not have been a good engineer. You know, I could have been a math teacher. That's where the passion was with the math.
Yeah.
You know, but that's seriously so important, because I remember that was one of the biggest things giving up music was the simple fact of I can't see this as a sustainable future.
I heard your album.
But they were trying to sign me. I didn't worry about you.
I think you would have been success in that too.
Thank you so much.
Because of the way you proceed. Hey, what man, I have to say this,
you know? See how beautiful she is now?
Oh, yeah.
My God. You should have seen her pictures when, you know, like, years ago. Just like amazing.
Say just last year.
Super fine.
See, he's trying to make points.
He's trying to get you illustrated second book.
She's super fine.
But no, what was it like, you know, discovering that purpose or understanding that purpose of saying this is what I'm supposed to do in life? What really helped you come to that decision? Because I think so many folks still haven't.
Well, it was a lot. I think when I dropped out of school, I was disappointed in myself that I didn't know what I wanted to do. And my mother, I had created an album for the sorority that I brought home. And she said, "Baby, this is so beautiful. This is," she said, "I'm so proud of this." Mm-hmm. She stressed that to me. She didn't get on me for dropping out, you know.
Wow.
Well, I think one of the things I wanted to ask you is about was how did you get past the practical? I heard when you said, when you first looked at it, it wasn't practical, but you broke through that barrier and you said, you know, what isn't practical still might be right. And you broke through that.
I can't say it was an evolution, you know, over time, you know, and I had time to be, a lay person, you know, raising a family and that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think I went back to school when my daughter was maybe 8.
Okay.
Which was a good model too, right?
No, not doing you. I'm sorry. I got to take it back. She was much younger than that. Anyway, kindergarten.
But she's describing the process of coming to discover yourself.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And then making adjustments.
And the beautiful advice that we got out of that was a simple fact of, the things you're going to regret in life is the things that you didn't try. Most of the stuff that you fail at least you know.
Yeah.
Because that not knowing and looking back, trying to figure out, I could have done this, I could have done that, that is the biggest nightmare that you never had to deal with in your life.
Yeah.
Like, seriously.
And I'm really inspired that she worked through that whole practical thing. Because a lot of times we overthink it and we say, well, this makes sense. And we let other people tell us what's realistic. Mm-hmm. It's so funny because we idolize people that did unrealistic things. But then we put ourselves in boxes and put people around us in boxes because this is realistic.
Exactly.
Yeah. Oh, Jeff is preaching.
I get a moment every now and again.
And the thing about regret, do we have time?
You got 1 minute.
The thing about regretting only what I haven't done is what I think is key to me going forward. What holds you back is not trying. You're going to fail if you don't try. And you may fail if you do try, but you definitely already failed if you haven't tried. That's what you get out of it. Go ahead and try and don't be embarrassed about what people call failure. It's just a stepping stone to learning and going forward.
That's going to be a quote for the day.
That's a quote for the day.
It is.
Ladies and gentlemen, if anybody wants to get in contact with you or support your artwork or just see some of this beautiful stuff that you've got right here on your website, please give everybody the website. We've already put it in the comments on social media, but please give everybody your website so they can find it.
It's my name, Vivian McDuffie, spelled VivianMcDuffie-artist.com.
And I promise you should go and check out the site today. It is some beautiful artwork there. You can see all the beautiful artwork that she has displayed in New Jersey. I mean, it is a wonderful experience.
Thank you.
It has
in Jersey.
It has been another Mindset Monday. right here on the Real 1100 AM iHeartRadio. It's the number one rated business show. Once again, if you are having trouble with your business, if you are trying to get it growing or get it going, give us a shoot us an email at connect@kevincpride.com. Just put in the subject line, I want help with my business. Jeff and I are teaming up to help a few businesses out here, help you get growing, yeah, help you change that bottom line by a few 10, 20, 30, $40,000.
Make sure you don't talk about Jeff's wife, though.
Yeah. And if you need help getting yourself together, I am opening up slap therapy.
Jeff is now a life coach.
Yes.
He will slap you right.
Slap therapy. And it comes in two different styles. Forehand and backhand.
And the magic pimp slap. Lord have mercy. Once again, is the number one rated business show right here on Real 1100 AM iHeartRadio, taking it all over the world. Thank you to everybody on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, LinkedIn, and Instagram. Thank y'all so much for joining us. We'll be back tomorrow at 10 a.m. We'll be live once again with another Tough Talk Tuesday. You can follow me on Instagram at I am KC Pride.
And you can follow me at Mr. Marketology.
And you can follow me at Astrologic Astrology.
And special thanks to Lorenzo Sanford, as always, for giving us the astrological forecast for the week. Y'all remember, keep it conservative this week.
Yeah.
Stay out the pork belly.
I'm going to call my broker today.
And y'all can check the restream of this episode. Tonight at 10 p.m. we'll be restreaming this on all our social channels. So y'all make sure y'all stay tuned for that. Until tomorrow, we are out.
Whoa.
You gonna lie to Kevin, watch when I catch, I'ma whack you in front of the witness. My you tripping, we could have been superstars. Remember when we were jacking cars? Now it's not safe for you. You switch like a my you tripping, we could have been superstars. Can't help it, now I'm reminiscing. Remember when we were jacking cars? Now you better keep your distance, cause it's not safe for you. You switch like a look.